Good morning, all. Respected gentlemen on the dais, EQ Anandji, who has invited us, all the distinguished audience here. I am Vinit Mittal. Our company name is Navitas Solar. We are based in Surat, Gujarat. We have a solar module manufacturing unit of about 200 megawatt per annum yearly capacity, and having operations pan India. We have warehouses and sales offices in a couple of cities, 6-7 cities. Being a distributed solar conference here, I'd like to touch upon some points which we feel, which is also our major market where we are selling our products, what our customers are experiencing, what experience we have gained from them, and I'd like to touch upon some points. We also happen to do some rooftop EPC for the industrial and commercial scale customers. So obviously we are talking about the solar sector to grow, and from the times of a megawatt in the utility to the times of 1 megawatt on the rooftop. So the industry has grown very far, and quality for the whole system in the installation phase during the maintenance is of utmost importance, as already discussed by Mr. Sharma. So we have been facing issues at industry level for the power quality that they are getting from the grid side when we synchronize our solar system with their existing setup. We have been facing issues of earthing, issues of harmonics in the industry where the peak load and the low side in power demand is, the ratio is very high. So lot of issues are faced because the wavelength at which the power is to be supplied in the meters, they are not available, and the inverter keeps on tripping down because they have a certain range within which they work. So before taking up any jobs, it's very important that a power analysis of the customer is done, and based on that, if there is any requirement of any active passive filters or some such stabilizers who can improve the power quality, which will ultimately benefit the customer also, because he'll be saving on the losses from the, say, ST line of 11 kV to a 415 volts. So that's of very important. And then we install the solar system, because we have seen the systems being installed, but they are down. They're down because the these things were not taken care initially. One important thing in this distributed solar is that MNR is running a whole scheme of empaneling new channel partners. So we have existing channel partner scheme and the new entrepreneur scheme. And currently we have about 2,000 plus channel partners across the country. It's very important that these channel partners are trained very well, because we keep on hearing that every other electrical contractor is now looking to get into solar and become a channel partner, and then they come to the customer and say, we are MNRE approved, so our quality will be good, so you can give us the job and we know this thing. And without understanding much about the solar, I am talking about ground level, I'm not talking of very glorious things, but issues which are faced at the bottom level. So it's very important that the channel partners are monitored, the quality of the work that these people, as in even we are the channel partner, so every channel partner has to be accountable for the systems that they are installing. And MNR is having a lot of efforts also. They are having a spin portal where we have to register our systems on a periodical basis, and they even blacklisted few companies who are not updating the data. So it's very important that the channel partners follow the quality norms for the modules, for the inverters, for the whole system as a whole, and are they maintaining the system for the first 1 or 2 years or 5 years as per the contracts. So that's very important. Again, talking about distributed solar, we have understood a lot about the pumping business, the home lighting business, the street lighting, towers. All these systems are the places where we get the actual benefit of solar, because solar then is generated at the point of final consumption, so we don't lose on the transmission network, which currently in India is very high. About, say, we are hearing figures of about 25% transmission losses in the utility scale. So when solar is installed on the distributed level, that is of prime importance for the country, where we feel or we hear that still about 40% is unelectrified or under-electrified. So distributed solar in no sense is going to be, I mean, it is going to be always important. So yes. Few other issues that we face in the rooftop large scale industries is the DG synchronization, because they all have diesel generators as a backup. and to synchronize with solar when the grid goes down. So the calculation has to be optimum, otherwise the solar system is not optimally utilized. So one important thing that we can think about is that we are learning new things in solar every day. Being a large country, we have various experiences in different parts of the country, and as a country, it's an opportunity for us to go global in the African parts, in the Middle East, in the Southeast Asia, where the International Solar Alliance, which has been announced by the Honorable Prime Minister, where all these newer the developing countries are looking for solar. So they are looking for guidance from countries like India, where we can explain them and we can customize solutions for them and we can go there and install systems for them. So that's a very big opportunity that we feel that it's going to come for India. These are the few points that I want to touch upon and don't want to extend the session further. Thank you.